Hello everybody, my name is Charlie and I'm a second year natural sciences student at UCL. In this video I'm going to be giving a bunch of tips, tricks, techniques that have helped me to pass my exams. So let's get started. Teaching to understand. I found this to be one of the most important parts of my revision. If you can't fully explain a concept to somebody, then do you really understand it? One particular technique that I found useful is the Feynman technique, named after the Nobel Prize winning physicist Richard Feynman. The technique is rather simple, but it kind of goes as follows. First, you've got understanding the key concepts. So this is when you're reading lecture material, notes, textbooks, and you're trying to understand and work out basically what's happening. Then the second stage is the teaching part. When you're teaching what you've just learned, where you're trying to pretend that you're explaining what you've just learned to a toddler or someone with very limited understanding of the topic. So you can either just pretend that someone's watching, or you can just find someone to teach if you've got any friends that are willing to listen. And yeah, onto the third steps, you've got, after you've taught, you're filling in the gaps. What didn't you understand? What couldn't you explain properly? What did you forget? This is when you're returning back to the source material and filling up these gaps. Onto the fourth step, you're simplifying and developing a proper understanding of the topic. This is when you're kind of distilling the key concepts, you're perhaps creating analogies. So that's point number one overall. The second main tip that I have is that you should be doing as many tests, or I think you should be doing as many tests and practice exam papers as possible.
And if you don't have many exam papers to use, then one of the other tips I've found useful is to use a textbook and to write
a big long list of questions. And then by writing lots of questions, I then added good material later on to test myself. So, point number three is spaced repetition. So this would be the act of spacing out revision over a longer period of time, rather than cramming it all in at once and doing a 10-hour study session or something. So the science has been around for quite a long time, since this psychologist called Ebbinghaus, who developed this forgetting curve, showing that our attention gradually decreases over time, but by regularly reviewing what we've forgotten, we can boost our long-term retention, basically. So I found that this idea of spacing out your revision practice is good when, say for instance, you have four topics in an exam. Rather than just going through one by one by one by one over 2 weeks, it would be better to do a little bit of one topic, do a little bit of another, come back to the first topic, then do a little bit of another, come back to it, and you're constantly doing smaller, more focused bursts of studying, rather than just focusing on each big topic at a time. So the fourth point is just to experiment and see what works best for you. For example, I know some people who really like going to libraries, and that is the only place they can study. But I've found that I don't really like them, as I do tend to talk to myself and explain things. And obviously, you've kind of got to be silent in a library. I've also found that there's so many distractions in a library, and there's people getting up and moving and then whispering to their friend, and I just prefer to be somewhere quiet where I know I'm not going to easily get distracted. So yeah, I've kind of experimented and I found that I work best in my room for a few hours. I usually put on some study music without lyrics, as yeah, then I can get distracted again. I've also found that the most optimal time for me to study without properly getting distracted is usually about 55 minutes, and then I usually go and maybe go and get a tea or go on a little walk. So I have this little tomato on my Google Chrome as an extension, and then that will alert me and give me a 5 minute break. Yeah, some people I know, they can only manage 20 minutes and then they need a little break. I usually find that I'm kind of in a bit of a flow that I don't really want to stop then. I've also found that I can't really sit on my desk the whole day. So then I usually will go out with maybe a couple of friends, or I'll go to a library or a coffee shop. I know I said I didn't like libraries earlier. Just my final tip, just to experiment, see what works for you and change things up, and keeping it interesting, basically. So that's that. There's 4 study tips. Hopefully you've taken away something useful from this video. And thank you for watching.